Hello and welcome to Ukraine Today. I'm Volodymyr Solhub, and right now I'm joined by the aviation's expert and lawyer, Mr. Andriy Huk, to discuss about the sanctions which Ukraine introduced against Russian air companies just last week. Andriy, welcome to Ukraine Today.
Hello.
Andriy, following the introduction of individual sanctions by the Ukrainian government towards Russian individuals and companies on September 16th, last week the Cabinet of Ministers of Ukraine announced that starting from October 25th, a number of Russian airlines, including such major airlines as Aeroflot and Transaero, will be banned from flying into Ukrainian airports. Andriy, can you tell us and our viewers what does that mean for the Ukrainian aviation market?
Well, it has meaning not only for Ukrainian aviation market, but also for Russian. And any sanctions, the question is, who will suffer more, Ukrainian side or Russian side? For my opinion, at this moment, Russian side will suffer more because airlines are the most sensitive enterprises to any sanctions, because there are huge money flow and huge passengers flow, and it depends from it very much. If you have such element as routes between Ukraine and Russia, and they are provides you some income and allows to donate some other routes that is not quite money, brings lots of money, it means that you will have to restructure the whole net of your routes. And for Aeroflot that suffers from other sanctions from European Union, from USA, it will matter probably too much. Probably it will be that even some kind of trigger that will let them down.
Yeah, but obviously Ukrainian side will suffer as well. And I understand that there are already reports that these sanctions will cost the Ukrainian aviation industry from 50 to 100 million annually. What are these losses? Where do they come from?
First of all, it's aeronavigation enterprise, Ukrainian Aeroruch, that receives money from each plane that goes or through Ukraine or to Ukraine. It is, of course, the huge amount of money is from Russian side, from Russian airlines that not only fly to Ukraine and also fly through Ukraine. That's why Ukraruch will be the first entity that will suffer from the sanctions from
so
Ukraine.
So basically, this is something like the air traffic controller, right?
Yes. Everything connected with air navigation services is this entity. The second one is airports. Boryspil, Zhuliany, Odessa, Lviv, the whole airports where Russian airlines flying will suffer, of course, much. And the Ukrainian passengers who using Moscow as transfer, as hub, or fly to Russia, of course they will suffer.
Yeah, let's talk a bit more about the passengers. I understand it's not only about changing of routes by the Ukrainian passengers, but also the price for the tickets. Obviously the price for the tickets will go up because Aeroflot was obviously a cheap airline. It was a lot of Ukrainians used Moscow as a hub for layover and traveling overseas to the US, to North America, as well as to Asia, where the airfare was extremely cheap for Aeroflot. So obviously, with that not on the in the picture, the prices will go up. Is that correct?
Of course, it's not only the matter of price, it's also a matter of time, because if you will need to restructure your air route through Istanbul, for example, or Minsk, or Baltic countries, of course, your time for your air route will expand. And money issue, of course, is also the question, because lots of tickets were sold for the dates after 25th of October. So now Aeroflot and other Russian companies will have to give back the price of unused tickets. This is as a minimum. As a maximum, some compensation should be paid. And it is a lot of money, because the whole flights will be canceled.
Yeah, but well, you mentioned that Ukrainians will be rerouting their flight patterns using the other hubs such as Baltics and Istanbul. So do you think that these hubs will benefit from these sanctions?
Of course they will. First of all, it's Istanbul, because it's a huge hub, especially if you go east. The only option is Istanbul, and it will be something like monopoly for all the routes that are going left from Ukraine. And Minsk and Baltic rights, that everything just goes right from Ukraine. So they will for sure benefit, and for sure they will put price understanding the whole picture that is going on now on air traffic in this region.
So in your estimates, how much will the prices go up?
Oh, it's hard to say because if they will be fighting for the passenger, of course they will try to increase not much, but if the passenger traffic will be huge, I think it will be a matter of price. So if you have too much passengers but too low number of flights, of course you will put a higher price in order to earn more.
Andriy, then the Russian government has already announced that they will introduce similar sanctions against Ukrainian airlines and Ukrainian air companies. But do you know, I understand that for the Russian companies, there is a list of specific air companies against which the sanctions are introduced. What about the Russian side? Will there also be a list of targeted Ukrainian companies, or will there be a total ban of flying into Russia for Ukrainian companies?
You see, when Ukraine imposed the sanctions, we left something like a window for to leave air connection between our countries. First of all, we used the principle that every airline that flown to Crimea Peninsula will suffer from sanctions. And the only airline from Russian side who didn't fly to Crimea, it was UTAIR. And it is left the only company that can fly to Ukraine. I think that from Russian side, if it will be a mirror measures, of course they likely to leave some one or two Ukrainian companies that will have a right to fly to Russia. From Ukrainian side, around five companies that has right to fly to Russia at the moment. So I think one of them will be left. If not, if it will be a total ban, I am for sure can guarantee that Ukrainian side also will ban UTAIR from so close the window totally, and we will have situations that like between Georgia and Russia, so the whole air connection between countries will be lost. And when it will be renewed, it's hard to say.
Understood. And Andriy, and very briefly, a final question. Do you think we can expect similar sanctions toward other forms of transport, namely the rail? There is like a huge connection between Kyiv and Moscow by rail, and also other Ukrainian cities.
I think at the moment, airlines probably would be the end at the moment. Why? Because airlines, this is the only way to fly or to go to Crimea. They have no other options. Railway connection is lost there also. And that's why to, let's say, punish airlines, it was significant at the moment just to stop flights to Crimea or try to stop. That's why I think it will be not more.
Yeah, but obviously with banning for the Russian airlines to fly into Ukraine, it doesn't prevent them from flying into Crimea via Russia, right? This is something we should do right now.
Eventually it could, because Ukrainian aviation authority fines Russian airlines every day for every flight. And these fines are increasing constantly. So if they want to fly or use Ukrainian territory to fly east or west or down, they will need to either pay fines for every flight to Crimea or stop to fly to Crimea. That's why this sanction has some few aims, and I hope it will work eventually.
Yeah, talking about the fines, this is a very interesting subject which you touched. How realistic it is to enforce these fines? Obviously, Ukrainian government can fine the Russian airlines for $1 or $1 million, but how realistic is it to enforce them?
I personally think that it is realistic, because every airline sells their tickets through specific BSP clearing houses, and even if they don't fly to Ukraine, they are selling tickets. Ukrainian passenger can buy a ticket, for example, from Moscow to elsewhere and fly to Moscow through Minsk. That's why Aeroflot and Transair and other Russian airlines has money in Ukraine. It's just a matter of expertise and knowledge to find them. So I hope lawyers will help Ukrainian aviation authority, and they will eventually find them.
Well, we'll follow this story development really closely. Andriy, many thanks for finding the time and talk to us and explain these intricacies of the sanctions against Russian companies. This was Vladimir Solub for Ukraine Today, together with the aviation expert and lawyer, Mr. Andriy Huk. Thank you for watching us.